It was the 60s when Jane Elliott devised her exercise. She was a school teacher in a small, all-white American town. America in 1968 was a segregated country. Black Americans were dying, battling for their basic civil rights. When Martin Luther King was assassinated, it had a profound effect on Jane Elliott. She was determined to find a way to show her 8-year-old pupils what was wrong with racism.
You think you know how I would feel to be judged by the color of your skin? No, I don't think you'd know how that felt unless you had been through it, would you?
She wanted them to understand how discrimination by something as arbitrary as eye color is unfair and illogical, as it is to discriminate on the basis of skin color.
Okay, how many in here have brown eyes? It might be interesting to judge people today by the color of their eyes.
I watched what had been marvelous, cooperative, wonderful, thoughtful children turn into nasty, vicious, discriminating little third graders. They were ghastly.
When you do this exercise in a kind way, people think you're weak and they do not listen. Do I have your attention? Yeah. Do I have your attention? Oh, yeah, damn right. And I intend to have your attention because there's nothing polite about racism. The purpose of this exercise is to let these nice blue-eyed white folks find out how it feels to be something other than white in the UK for 2.5 hours. They are not going to like it because I don't like them. They've already been abusive, they've already been belligerent, they've already tried to make a joke of something. Can you make a joke of racism?
No, I can't.
No, I didn't think so. Can you make a joke of racism? Can you make a joke of racism? Let me put it this way. You laugh and I'll change the color of your eyes so fast you won't know what hit you. You got it? Okay. You get angry about racism?
Hey, yeah, all the time.
You do, all the time? Yeah. Why, is there something wrong with you?
No.
No? Is there something wrong with racists?
Yes.
Damn right. If you want to see a decrease in the level of racism in your society, the first thing you have to do is let white people find out how it feels to be on the receiving end of it.
Jane Elliott's abrasive style is not to everyone's taste. Over the years, it has been criticized as bullying. How do you feel about Jane's style and approach?
This is an educator, a teacher, trying to teach these people what it is like to feel discriminated against.
Something that's been incredibly important to her in her personal life and in her role as a teacher. And she's saying, with this, I can powerfully demonstrate to a set of people what it's like to be the victim of racism and discrimination.
But brown-eyed adults are much tougher to bring into line than children. And Jane Elliott's style soon hits a nerve with some of the white volunteers.
What they learn today, they will either leave in this room or take out of them this room in a very positive way.
But these people are people. You're assuming
now,
that they're
what?
Racist. You're assuming they've got a lesson to be learned. You know, we could be racist.
Oh, like, I'm sure you are.
You,
I'm sure every
racist,
person
why,
in every person in this room.
That
let
they,
me. You didn't listen to me.
You're assuming I've got a racist attitude just because they're blue eyes.
If you live in, if you live
but
in the UK,
you're saying that they've got more to learn.
I just think the logic's a bit faulted to try and reduce discrimination, racism.
Listen, Sonny, I don't care what you think.
Racism.
I don't care what you think. Do you understand that?
But isn't it kind of contradictory?
Do I give a damn? Do I care? You,
so,
you trade places with him. Right now.
Why?
Not because I told you to. That's the only reason you need. Go back there.
Yes, sir. Mom, whatever.
Some of us white folks would rather not see white folks verbally, psychologically, mentally, and emotionally abused for a few minutes. would rather not hear white folks described in an unpleasant way for a few minutes. Did you get that lesson? Did you get that message? Now, if you consider this exercise too evil for you to go through it, then you need to be somewhere else.
I would much rather be on the blue-eyed side than the aggressive side.
I don't care where you'd rather be. Now, are you going to cooperate or not?
I'm saying I would much rather be on the receiving end.
I'm asking you if you're going to cooperate or not.
It's an exercise for them to understand this is what comes to you because of how you look. It's a learning process.
It's an exercise that removes choice and freedom and autonomy.
But you don't have a choice. I don't have a choice to be a black woman. It was assigned to me when I came into this world. You are a black female.
The choice that I'm talking about is a choice of whether I decide to be an aggressor, to be someone who marginalizes these people.
Look, wait a minute. I don't have time. I do not have time to convince this young man that what we're doing is all right. There's no way I'm going to convince him of that, and I'm not going to spend any more time on it. Get this young man out of here.
What do you think is the effect of her throwing him out on the rest of them?
The majority of this group are committed to what she wants to do. And notably, it's the white members of the group who are uncertain about it and unhappy about it.
And now another one's walking out.
People in majority positions, powerful positions, whites, for example, don't see there's a problem with racism. And it's a really fundamental problem. They just don't see there's an issue. And this is what we're getting here as well, is that the white people in this brown-eyed group are kind of saying, look, do we really need to do this? Is it really necessary? And she's trying to convince them, and the rest of the group are convincing them that it is necessary.
Now, if you think I'm being too harsh on her and him, you ain't seen nothing yet. All I want you to do is act white. You white folks know how to act white. You've been doing it all your lives. You know how to act white? Sure you do. You know how to act white? You know how to act white?
Not really.
Well, can you when you have to?
Just look down your nose at everyone.
Can you? Can you when you have to?
Yeah, I suppose so.
Do you know how to act white?
Of course.
Oh, sure you do. You know you do, and I know you do.
With two volunteers gone, Jane Elliott seems to have quelled the brown-eyed dissent. But back in the 60s, when she divided her original school class, she was shocked by how readily the brown-eyed group took to their superiority.
What happened, John?
Russell called me names and I hit him in the gut.
She was even more alarmed by the blue-eyed group. They gave up. Their heads went down. They underperformed. Jane Elliott felt she had seen the world in microcosm. Her exercise showed what racism was, an immoral and irrational social construct that people were far too quick to sign up to. Since then, she's put adults all over the world through her exercise, and her approach has become more confrontational.
You're either my way or the highway. Do it my way or get out of here.
Nicely.
Out of here. Whether or not I like them, we're going to let these people in here. And you're going to see to it that they understand that we have created a situation for them to learn. That we did this for their own good. And how should they feel about that?
Thankful.
Grateful. And if they aren't grateful, what does that prove about them? They're ignorant. They're ingrates. No matter what you do for them, it isn't enough. That's just the way these people are.
The Blues have now been waiting in the holding room for 2 hours.
Time to go, then.
That's the time, too.
They're about to discover what it's like to be on the receiving end of Jane Elliott's dictatorial regime.
If one of these boys tries to come at me, what are you going to do?
Protect you.
Protect me, thank you very much. Change places with her.
So what do you think is going to happen when the Blues come in there? Quick predictions.
I think the Blues are going to stick together.
I do agree with Dominic, they will stick together. I think one person will probably leave.
Get in here and sit down. They look very intelligent to you? Look very aware? You're not sitting in the brown-eyed group. Get up here and sit down. You're not sitting in the brown-eyed group. Get up here and sit down.
My initial reaction was, we're into a them and us situation.
I spotted immediately that the group of the brown-eyed people were looking very aggressively at us. They were looking very negatively at us, and I knew immediately that we were in for it.
Oh.
Her mission is to grind down the blue eyes.
You know what a redundancy is? Mm. What?
They give you money and you leave your job.
Once they're feeling downtrodden, what they learn from this can be a real revelation.
Who's responsible for you being on the hot seat right now?
I am.
Thank you very much. Now, does that teach you something?
That I have to listen to you.
Is that all?
And I have to conform to the way you want me to be and not how I am.
Yeah. Does that teach you something?
Yeah. That I'm insignificant.
Yeah. Does that teach you something?
Yeah.
Yeah. What does that teach you?
I'm worthless.
What does that teach you? If I can make you, if I can convince you that you're worthless for 45 minutes, what could I do if I did this with you for 30 years?
You could take away my self-being and who I am.